Hi, I'm Will.
I'm Luke.
And I'm Jason from Speedcast.
And today we're testing the Starlink Maritime Terminal on the water. So we have a set of maritime terminals. We don't have a yacht to test it on, but as engineers, we want to test it in the worst possible situation. So we're putting it on a center console. We're going to do some easy trials with it today. We want to drive it forward, see how it does in moving. We want to do some turns and we want to get it on the ocean and see how it does. So we have a 27-foot Ocean Master as our test vehicle today. Let's go get started.
Conditions here is we're coming out of the Sebastian Inlet. The tide's going out at the moment. Conditions are choppy as we expected. We're going to be hitting the real rough stuff here in just a moment. But other than that, the skies are clear. Everything looks good.
After the initialization process. All right, so both antennas are now pointed roughly north.
You can see that it took a bit of time here for the system to actually start. Okay, so now we've completed our test. We performed a series of turns to evaluate the performance as the boat and the antennas were moving. The antennas appeared not to move. They appeared to hold a single position and performed well through most of the movements. We started with initial 90 degree turns very slowly. We did a second run at a very slow, smooth turn and then a fast, smooth turn. We did see performance degrade during the turns, especially at speed, but we maintained connectivity and always had performance through the process.
Still haven't dropped out. We have about 2 to 3 foot wake here in front of us.
While at speed, we found that the performance was stable at 10, 15, 20, up to 40 knots in 5-knot increments during our testing.
All right, here we are passing under the bridge. So we'll see if there's any blockage created by that that might give us problems with the signal. Any drop pings or anything yet, Will? Okay.
Drop some pings. Drop.
There it goes. Dropped a few.
Right as we went under the bridge, it looks like we did drop out. How long until it comes back?
It's already back.
It's already back.
It's
so
back.
Just a brief. The bridge.
Yep. Brief time we were physically blocked by that bridge.
Test results for our boat trial were very encouraging. We found overall that the system performed very well. We found that it maintained connectivity through various boating conditions and sea states, passing under bridges, obstructions, doing turns at speed. We certainly learned that the mounting is very crucial. You don't want to have small movements to it. It's important to make a rigid mount. We did observe that it is very much like having a home internet connection on your boat. So if you're a enterprise user, be mindful of how you bond the two systems together to get a seamless blockage experience, how you can tunnel across the internet, bring a corporate link, and see some of the other features that we're going to bring you through our Sigma demo.
Now, so far in our maritime testing that we've done, we haven't found a way to bond the two or connect the two Starlink systems together to act as one seamless system to the end user. So what we're going to do now is we're going to use the Speedcast SigmaNet product to do that. The SigmaNet lets us take multiple WANs and combine them for one seamless user experience. It also lets you extend your corporate network out to your remote site. So imagine for a minute that you could have a corporate LAN, you could have a crew Wi-Fi LAN, you could have an important data or telephony LAN all on one device. You could do port forwarding so that you can access equipment on the remote site. And all of that is built into this box here. It also does firewalling, crew Wi-Fi, telephony, and many other features.